In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create kinetic typography super quick using hold keyframes and an expression. This entire text block was created using just one text layer. Impress your clients or your boss in just a few minutes with this kinetic typography technique. Hey everybody, and welcome back to another exciting and informative episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in 7 minutes or less. No BS, just AE. This tutorial will give you a better understanding of using text animators as well as hold keyframes. Now there are a ton of ways to create kinetic typography, and this is just one of those ways. This technique is super helpful, especially if you're in a time crunch. This episode is sponsored by the good people over at Envato Elements. Visit them today using the link in the description below and get an amazing 70% off your first month. Envato Elements has everything a serious motion graphic designer could possibly want or need. Check out their promo at the end of this tutorial and make sure to tell them that Jeff Knight from 7-Minute AE Tutorials sent you. Once you sign up, you won't remember how you ever animated before Envato Elements. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. And click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Support our channel by getting your 7-Minute AE merch today at our online store. And sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's guaranteed to make you a shape layer rockstar. The link to that course, to our 7-Minute AE store, the amazing discount from Envato Elements, and the project files for this episode are all in the description below. I've also included a table of contents so you can go back and rewatch sections that you found difficult. Okay, there's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Okay, so we're in a 1920 by 1080 comp, and I've got this audio file right here that we'll be creating our kinetic typography for, so let's just listen to that real quick. This kinetic typography was created on one text layer and animates with hold keyframes and just one text animator. So let's just drag in the audio. So I'm going to start typing this kinetic typography, and it doesn't really matter right now where you're text is located. We're going to be tweaking that later, but I want to get a little bit closer to the center, and then we'll make some adjustments as we go along. So this kinetic typography was created on one text layer and animates with hold keyframes. And I'm just going to pull up my leading so we don't run out of space here. And just one text animator. If your rulers aren't up, you can hit Command or Control R to bring them up. And one of the cool things about these rulers is you can bring them over. And if you right click on the ruler, you can get an exact position for this ruler. So I wanted this to be about 560 pixels in. I'll bring out another ruler, right click. And we'll just say 1920 minus 560. These are going to be the borders of our text layer. Actually, I'm going to go ahead and get this officially centered. So transform, center anchor point, and layer content. And then align this. So this is perfectly centered, but now we need to adjust the width of all of our text layers here. Just a quick note, I'll be referring to adjusting the leading of these text lines. Now leading is the distance between two baselines of lines of text, whereas kerning is the space between two letters of text. So let's highlight this first layer here and then adjust our size from the character control panel. So the T and the Y are touching both of these rulers. Second layer was created on one. Text layer is gonna be a lot larger. Bring our leading down here so we have some space. And animates width, just a little bit bigger. Hold is going to be huge. Let's bring that down. Keyframes is going to be a little bit bigger too. Bring that leading down. And I'm just going to move my text. That way we can see what we're doing. We'll say, and just one. And actually, I think I'm going to put text animator on one line so that way it's not so tall. So this is basically what our box text is going to look like. You can get it a little more perfect, like if you want to get the leading perfect between each one of these lines of text. Okay, now if we right click, transform, again, center anchor point layer content, align that right up, and then I'm just going to bring up my scale and come down to about maybe 90%, so that way we have some padding around this. Okay, and get rid of these rulers here. Now I'm just going to change some of the colors in here just to kind of give it some more variety, so maybe this first line here is like a blue. You know, something like an orange. And this is just completely arbitrary. I'm just showing you some things that you can possibly do with some of this kinetic typography to give it a little bit more life. You know, so just make this however you want to make it. Highlight the audio layer and again hit LL if it's collapsed. And I'm going to bring the layer to where the first word is going to be. And I like to use a text animator that's already built into After Effects. So start typing in your Effects and Presets panel, typewriter. Just double click that. And if we hit U to bring up our keyframes, We can actually get rid of both of these keyframes and increase this start percentage to 100. Open up our range selector, open up advanced, and change based on characters to based on words, because we're going to be animating each word in as it said. If you want to animate it by syllable, then you would have characters. But for purposes of this tutorial, we're going to use words. We'll be using our start percentage to animate this. So let's just put a keyframe at the very beginning of this layer, and we're going to roll this 100% back to where we only see this. So now right click and toggle this to a hold keyframe. So at this point, I'm just going to start animating in these words without really worrying about timing. I just want to get the words in first. So say this kinetic typography, and say I'm just increasing my start percentage to bring in each word was created on one text layer and animates with hold keyframes and just one text animator. So the main thing we want to establish here is that each word comes in at a time and we don't have any words that are skipping. So now at this point, what we're going to do is time these keyframes up to our audio. You can visually go by your audio waveform and kind of predict how some of these are going to come in. So, you know, animators right here. So we're just going to kind of go through here and line up these hold keyframes with the audio. Now I'm speeding through this part for the sake of time, but the main thing to remember is that you want your keyframes to be lined up with the first sound of the word that it corresponds with. So now if we watch this playback, the main thing we're looking for is that the words are timed with the audio. This kinetic typography was created on one text layer and animates with hold keyframes and just one text animator. Perfect. So now I want to animate this so that this text box is always centered. So if you get your quotation marks, we get our safe margins here. And then we're going to animate this using our position. So hold down shift and hit P to bring up our position. And we're just going to put a keyframe right here. Now if we hit U, we reduce everything other than our keyframes. Now we're going to eventually make our position keyframes also hold. It's not necessary to do that at this point. The way we want to animate this is whenever a new word comes in on a line, that's when our text box is going to move. So we have a keyframe right here because text is the first word of this line. Now we need to go to and. And as we can see, this is not centered any longer. So let's just move this down so it's centered. And then keyframes is on a line by itself. So we just move that down until it's centered. Hold is on a line by itself, so we can move that down as well. And the first word here is and. Move that down. Text is the first word of that line. And then we're looking for was, which is right here. I'm going to move that so that's centered. And this is obviously the first word of the first line. So now if you just highlight position, right click, choose toggle hold, and watch this playback. This kinetic typography was created on one text layer and animates with hold keyframes and just one text animator. So there are a lot of ways you can create kinetic typography. This is a very simple way of doing it. There are certainly more complicated ways. However, this is a very quick way that you can animate some kinetic typography using one text layer and some hold keyframes. I want to thank Envato Elements for sponsoring this episode and also thank my viewers for making this sponsorship possible. For designers, editors, and animators, Envato Elements is an amazing resource. With your membership, you can download unlimited assets for anything you could possibly want or need for your projects. Get access to high-res stock videos and photos, as well as motion graphic templates for titles, video displays, logo animations, lower thirds, infographics, promos, openers, and so much more. You also get access to backgrounds, textures, patterns, and icons, which we all know are vital resources. You get access to music for your sound beds in virtually any style or genre you can possibly imagine for designing the perfect sound for your projects. Speaking of sound design, you have access to Envato Elements' entire sound effects database, which includes any sound you could possibly need or want for anything from short film production to commercials to logo stingers. Every asset comes with commercial and non-commercial licensing at no extra cost, so both you and your clients can produce amazing projects with peace of mind. And again, with your membership, you get unlimited downloads of all of these assets from Envato Elements. Download as much as you want, as often as you want, without ever having to pay for individual projects or files. Check out Envato Elements from the link in the description below and get 70% off the first month. That means you have access to everything from Envato Elements for less than $10. It's an unbelievable deal, and I highly recommend you check it out. I hope this tutorial helped you out and that you learned something new and useful. I'm all about saving time, increasing efficiency, and learning as much as possible about motion graphics. Make sure to come back next time for another tutorial that will expand your knowledge of After Effects while also teaching you some really cool tips, tricks, and shortcuts. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. And click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Support our channel by getting your 7-Minute AE merch today at our online store. And sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers, is guaranteed to make you a Shape Layer Rockstar. The link to that course, to our 7-Minute AE store, the amazing 70% discount from Envato Elements, and the project file for this episode are all in the description below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.